In this image I shot, she's exceptionally dark. She's not exposed properly. The background is exposed nicely, but certainly not her. And so I want to go ahead and brighten her up. I can do that by selecting the mask. And in this case, I'm going to click entire person. I'll create the mask based on the entire subject. I can see here where this portion was omitted for some reason, but I'm not going to worry about adding back to the mask at the moment because it's not going to matter for what I'm trying to do, which is just to increase exposure, which is basically adding back in my light. I'm going to reduce highlight a little bit, but I'm definitely going to add back light into my shadows. And I'm really going to warm her up because she got really cool. So with those few clicks, look, we were here, now we're here. Such a significant difference. I'm going to go ahead now and drop my clarity slider. That's going to help smooth her skin out, kind of just everything, the hair, again, everything within that layer mask. It's not touching the background at all because I'm just working on the entire person layer masks. If I now want to work on the background, I create a new mask. I'm going to go ahead and select the background. And now I can go ahead and play there. I can drop my exposure a little bit, which will help with the separation. And now she's lit properly. Looks really great, but still kind of have that pretty hue in the background. I'm going to drop my highlights just a little bit. And I can go ahead and even add a little bit more contrast if I like. And that looks really, really pretty. So then if I want to make some global adjustments, meaning that anything I do now is going to affect both the subject and the background, I'm no longer working on masks, then I can come back into my basic panel, no longer on my mask, and I can make some adjustments. I'm going to go ahead and add into my shadows. I'm going to draw my whites a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and dehaze. And of course, I can go ahead and make proper, you know, horizon lines here, etc. But that's just a nice, clean, easy headshot that I would include in my gallery, even if it's not like an exceptionally creative portrait, just because I always like to, you know, throw in there the standard images as well. So we were here, now we're here. Definitely more popping than we were before. I could keep playing with that as I wished.
Join us at Photoshop World, September 24th through 26th. Learn more at photoshopworld.com.